Hi, this is Larry London. Welcome to Border Crossings. Today we have a very special guest. It isn't often we get to welcome somebody to the show that actually has the title and deserves the title, legend. We have a music legend with us today who's a member of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. And if the names like Poco, Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, and the Eagles sound at all familiar, then you'll know this guy who's with us today, Timothy B. Schmit. Welcome to Border Crossings on the Voice of America.
Thanks for having me.
It is great to have, I guess I should call you Dr. Schmit. I mean, because you actually have that doctorate from Berkeley, so you deserve to be called doctor.
You've been doing your homework.
I have. I'm studying you.
Yeah, no, you can skip the doctor. I mean, it is honorary.
Well, that's all right. You certainly, through your career and all your achievements, you've earned the respect of millions and millions of people, as well as universities such as Berkeley. I do want to start off by, first of all, asking you, how are you feeling? I know in 2012, you had a bout with throat cancer, and that's not something that a singer, you know, ever should have to deal with. But you obviously beat that, and you're okay?
Well, come Thanksgiving, it will be 10 years. I'm okay, yes.
That's wonderful.
It didn't happen without some effect, but I've learned to figure that out.
Mm-hmm. And how
that's
has...
Good. I'm healthy.
Well, that's great. That is great news. And let's talk about COVID first. We'll start off with the bad stuff. We'll get to the good stuff. COVID, it's in the rearview mirror. What's happening now with Timothy B. Schmit? You've got your new album, but are you going out on tour with the Eagles for your album? What's the plan now that COVID's behind us a bit?
Well, it's sort of behind us. It's flaring up, like in Los Angeles here, it's starting to flare up again. I'm still pretty much a masker when I go out into the world. I will probably try and book some shows for the fall.
Mm-hmm.
As a solo artist.
As a solo artist. You have accomplished so much as a solo artist and so much with bands and artists, and I know your new album, Day by Day, has all kinds of guests on it. Some other icons and legends in the music business have joined you, all your brethren. Was it always music for Timothy B. Schmit? Was this from the beginning? You knew this is, you know, growing up in Sacramento, you said, this is what I want to do?
Well, I always loved music. My dad was a musician. That's all he did all his life. He played played clubs, you know, all his life from the time he was very young. I was around it all the time. I was around music. And of course, I was listening to the radio a lot. And I can't say that I said, this is what I want to do. I was too young. I mean, but I was always incredibly attracted to it. And things sort of, not without some work, but in a lot of ways fell into my lap, and I'm very fortunate that way, because I believe that there's a ton of very talented people out there who just aren't going to have these kind of chances. In fact, I know that's true, so I'm very fortunate.
Yeah, you have been definitely blessed, and I know a lot of musicians I talk to, and I ask, okay, so you were in a band, quite a famous band, what prompted you to decide to do it? And they all say, well, the girls, you know, end of the day.
I have to say, it's always a lot of fun. In fact, when people say, I have parents sometimes ask me this, they say their children are getting into music. What sort of advice do you have to them? I don't really have any advice except for remember, if it takes you somewhere, or even if it doesn't, remember why you got into this then, and keep it fun. Remember it was because you were having fun. And that's, I think, really the key.
So what's the best advice you ever got, and who gave it to you?
My musician father, who didn't give me much advice. And one of the only things I remember him telling me was one night in high school, I was getting ready, putting on my band uniform, I think. And I think he saw something in my eyes that said, uh-oh, he's like going for this. He likes this. And he said to me, he said, look, if this takes you anywhere and people start writing about you, he said, you're going to read all kinds of stuff. And just remember, it doesn't matter what they say. The fact is, you'd be important enough to be written about it all is enough.
Mm. I think, you know, John Lennon said something very similar, you know, as long as they're talking about you. Timothy B. Schmit, who got his best advice from his dad. Now, what do you tell Jedra? I mean, she's performing with you. So what do you say to your daughter? This is, you know, what kind of advice, fatherly advice do you give her with the music business? Stay away from it? Or
no, she doesn't. Jethro's my oldest, and she's, you know, she's well into being a grown woman. I had her when I was in my 20s. She doesn't really perform with me, but she has contributed some vocals on a couple of my albums, including this one. And I don't really give her any advice. She made a really big go of it when she was younger. And you know, I could get my foot into the doors for people to hear her maybe, but I couldn't make them, you know, go for it or like it or want to do something. But she still does sing and play, but she also has a day job.
And your other two children also into music?
My son actually did a short run at Berklee College of Music. That didn't last, but he definitely was musical. I mean, he was accepted because of his talent. And then my other daughter is more of a visual artist, but her husband is a musician, and they do things together sometimes musically.
So you have been associated with a long break between albums. I don't know whether it be the Eagles that waited 16 years from The Long Run to The Long Road Out of Eden to your current album, which is Day by Day. And the last album you put out was Leap of Faith in 2016. Why do you wait so long in between albums?
Well, I'm pretty busy for one thing. I have my, you know, the Eagles are go out on and off. And sometimes, like right now, we're really busy. And so I would come home and on little breaks and try and write and record during those times. But also this is my third album out of seven that are completely, all the songs are composed by me. There's no collaborations. And I'm not particularly prolific speed-wise when writing. I take my time, I need the time. So I don't want to put out anything that hasn't had a lot of thought put into it or anything that I don't like personally. So it's just my pace. It's what I do all the time, either whether it's music is what I do all the time, whether it's with the Eagles or on my solo projects or maybe helping somebody else.
Well, I grew up, obviously, a lot of people tell you they grew up listening to your music with the Eagles, with Poco, you know, all the different music that you put out over the years. And of course, your own solo stuff that you've had very big success with. You were, you know, top of the charts as well. I'm talking to Timothy B. Schmit, in case you're just tuning in. And what a thrill it is for me to have you on the show, having sat, you know, in the first few rows watching the Eagles when they got back together in 2007 and started the tour again. And watching Hotel California, I mean, what's your favorite Eagles song to perform? Mine is Hotel California. How about yours?
Well, that question is asked to me a lot, and I'm always kind of in a quandary. There's a bunch of them. I mean, a lot of people ask the question, what do you attribute the Eagles' longevity to? And there's only really one true answer, and that is the songs, the quality of the songs. So there's a lot of them, and I do enjoy a lot of them. I can't pick one out. And that's also because of the quality of the songs that mostly Don and Glenn wrote, not completely, but the lion's share. That's what keeps performing these songs over decades fresh, is seeing the audience's reactions. I mean, I see people transformed. I see people cry every night. I see people mouthing the words and going into these different worlds and dancing and stuff. It's pretty great.
It's got to feel especially rewarding. You go to a country where people don't speak English and they know every word to every song you sing.
It's all great. I still can hardly believe that I'm still able to do this at my age on this level. So I have nothing.
If you,
claim.
If you had to pick a favorite part of the business, if let's say somebody made you choose Timothy B. Schmit, are you going to be a songwriter? Are you going to be a bass guitarist in a band and record albums? Or are you going to tour for the rest of your life? What are you going to pick?
Well, it's all the same. I mean, if you do one, you kind of have to do the others. It's mm-hmm. it's kind of one big package, and I am doing it. So
yes,
that's my answer.
You're living your best life.
Pretty much, yeah. Both professionally and personally, I think. Mm-hmm. So it's
yes,
a good deal.
And you have worked with not only bands like Poco and Crosby, Stills, Nash and Young, Steely Dan, but also you work with artists like the Elton John, I guess, Richard Marx. These are people I read that you had associated with.
I used to sing on a lot of records. I sang on a lot of artists. A long time ago, when I was in my early 20s, I met a producer here and there, maybe like, for instance, Steely Dan's producer. I met him and I said, if you ever need somebody to sing, I'm totally available. Not really thinking, you know, I was kind of thinking, yeah, sure. And they called me. And then it was kind of word of mouth, I think. So I was able to associate, as you say, but really more just on a, more as a singer than anything else for a lot of these people. I was able to be on a lot of records. And
well, you give a lot of people a lot of hope out there, just making it sound so easy. I just said, I'm available, and boom, then you got a call.
Well, you know, you can say you're available and they give you a try, I suppose. And there's just as much chance that they might not like you, you know, so whatever, you know.
So you have been a part of this business, and you, I'm talking to Timothy B. Schmit of the Eagles and Poco, and of course his solo fame, and the new album is Day by Day, his seventh album that's out now. And so you have seen the business transform in terms of even the technology, where you actually had to be in the same studio at the same time when you first mm-hmm. cut records, even as far back as Tim, Tom, and Ron, and you put out a record with Glad. In those days, you still had to be together. And nowadays you can phone it in. You don't have to be in the same room.
Yeah, that's true. You can send files to whoever you're singing with, or you can use my own studio and send files. My preference is, and then my last three albums, well, all of them really, my preference is to not do that. I like to be in the room because otherwise there's no back and forth in the moment. So I've had people you might know not be able to come here. So I didn't use them because I want them to be here. Everybody on my records have been in person. And I prefer it that way. It just makes more sense.
It's very organic, and that's the old style. That's the way it was done. And I agree with you. It's in person is always better than just kind of recorded and already set, you know.
There's a place for that other thing. I've sung for people from my own studio, and I'm trying to think if I ever did it for my own. No, I haven't. I always had people come in.
And your studio is Moose Lodge. Why do you call it that?
I don't know. I honestly can't remember why I came up with that. It's one word and it just stuck. So, and I just had the outside of the studio redone, mm-hmm. Sort of, you know, cosmetically, and over the door, over the entrance door, there's a tile with a moose on it.
Cool. Very homey.
I don't know why. Why not, right?
Don't you worry, sometimes you just gotta let it ride. The world is changing right before your eyes. Now I've found you, there's no more emptiness inside. keep us alive.
Timothy B. Schmit is talking with us. Where are you right now? You're at home in California, I assume?
This is one of the rooms in my studio in LA. Yeah. Mm-hmm. This is a room. It's sort of an office, but you can probably see mic stands back there. It's all wired up, and I have closed circuit TV in the other room for where the console is. So that's where I'm speaking from.
Do you remember where you were when you heard the Eagles for the first time on the radio?
Well, I knew those guys before they were the Eagles. And I actually, the first time I ever played with Don and Glenn was on a Linda Ronstadt record. I played bass, Glenn played guitar and Don played the drums. But as far as hearing them, I definitely do, because Poco had been in my other band that I was in. It wasn't my band, it was the other band I was in, was on the road a lot. We had already been going for a couple of years and we were traveling a lot. And I remember we used to play a lot of colleges and we would drive from one college to another. And I remember relentlessly hearing Take It Easy on the radio, which is now 50 years old.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
As of this month, that the Take It Easy, the first foray onto the American or radio airwaves was Take It Easy. And I remember hearing that all the time and going, you know, that's not happening with me or us.
Oh my gosh. 50 years. Wow. Does it seem like it went by fast, or does it seem like 50 years to you?
Well, everything seems to go faster now. All those cliches about time and moving faster are just all seem to be true. But in other ways, you know, it depends on how you look at it. You know, there's a lot of things happen in 50 years.
Hmm. I'm in awe of everything you've done. And do you have a highlight to this point? Or you haven't written an autobiography yet. I assume something will come out eventually. You'll want to tell your story.
I don't know. I don't know if I'm going to do that or not. Other people have approached me with that. And it seems to me like any of the really great stuff I probably wouldn't include. It wouldn't be fair to others, shall we say, or myself. So,
right, right.
So I don't know about that. Do I have a highlight? There's a lot. I have a lot of highlights. I mean, I have a list, you know. Mm-hmm. I mean, I used to go pay money to see the Beach Boys, for instance, when I was still playing surf music in Sacramento, and going to a live recording, and then, you know, skip to 10 years later, I'm singing with them. You know, it's like, it's mind-blowing stuff. A lot of people I never thought I'd ever be in the same room with, I've met. I actually got to meet all the Beatles, all separately. I did play with Ringo Starr as one of his all-stars one summer. And there's a lot, you know, there's a lot of accolades that, you know, are pretty nice, but the actual performing in front of a lot of people who are cheering and know these songs is probably a highlight almost every night.
And I guess if Randy Meisner sees you coming, he runs the other way. Is that how that works?
No, Randy and I are friends. You know, we used to joke, you know.
You've replaced him twice.
Shortly after I joined the Eagles, I ran into him and I said, well, what are you going to do next? Because people probably don't know, but I took his place in Poco.
Yes.
His place in the Eagles. Yes. So, you know, we have a good thing.
So, I mean, is there a song that you wish you would have recorded, a song either you wrote or were a part of writing and producing that you gave away that you say, gosh, I wish we would have done that. I wish I would have done that.
Well, I wish there was some sort of more exotic answer, but no, if I write a song that I really like, I'm not giving it to anybody. In fact, not too many people have recorded my songs at all. So
really,
yeah, a few here and there, but, I just write them and record them and then put it out and then do it all over again.
I can't tell you why. Love Will Keep Us Alive. These are just a couple of songs that the man I'm talking to today was the singer on. Of course, he's a big part of all of the Eagles' success. He was on most all of the Eagles' hits over the years, has toured as well. Timothy B. Schmit is our guest here, a member of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. That must have been a hoot when you found out you were going to be inducted. Probably not a surprise, though, for the Eagles.
Yeah, I mean, that's one of those, you know, those great events. And also the Kennedy Center Honors, you know, where I was, you know, hanging out with President Obama and his wife. It's like, it's pretty great. You know, I got to take my family there, my grown kids got to meet those people and be in the White House. And, you know, there's a lot of great stuff that's happened. You know, I'm very fortunate. What can I say?
Mm-hmm. Have you performed for kings and queens? And
actually, we performed for, I'm thinking, the Prince and Princess of Monaco. They had some kind of big party that they hired us to play at, and we got to meet them. But other kings and queens, I can't think of it.
Tell me about Day by Day. I want to know all about the new album. What's on the new album? What's the inspiration behind the album? I want to hear all about it.
Okay, well, basically, it's not a concept album or anything. Basically, it's that I write songs. Like I said before, I write songs. I might have one or I might have two, three, four songs. And I don't turn on the mothership, the studio, until I have something to record. I use the space to write in. It's just me and a guitar. There's no big... overall big concept when I start doing this. I figure something out. If I think it's worth pursuing, I pursue it. Sometimes it's easy. Most of the time it's not. It takes a lot of time, but I love the process. The process of writing and then having it come to fruition I want to say tape, but it's not tape anymore, is very satisfying. So basically I collect a bunch of songs I've written and record them, and I see if they will fit together in some sort of logical sequence, and that's how it's done. Mm-hmm.
Just that simple. You make it sound
well,
so
easy. The overall process is that simple. Yeah.
Wow.
I come alive. I feel so happy.
Schmit is our guest, and who inspires Timothy B. Schmit? Who are you listening to these days?
Oh, I listen to all kinds of different music. I listen to classical. I listen to jazz. I found this great station that plays Irish music, which is very, it has to be a lot of bluegrass, I think, came out of those countries. I mean, it's very similar in a lot of ways. I don't know, something I might like on the radio hits me. I think everything seeps in, you know, like I mentioned surf music when I was really young. Well, my band and I, when we finally found a drummer, we learned 14 surf songs in a day. They were all instrumentals. But at the same time, we turn on the radio and all you hear is Motown, you know, so it all comes in. It all seeps in.
Is that the GLAD you're referring to?
Well, yeah, GLAD was a horrible record company name that was bestowed upon us later on. But it's basically the same folk group, Tim, Tom, and Ron, plus a drummer, and through different names. Yes, yes.
Right. So, I mean, you know, the music that you started recording, you refer to yourself as a folk musician, folk singer, folk rock guy. And you listen to today's bands. I think we're missing that. I think we're really missing that in the business.
Probably us older folks are missing it. But there's a time and a place for everything. And I think it'll all come around again. And I don't want to be an old geezer saying, call that music. You know, back in my day, I'm not interested in that. I try to keep myself open. There's a lot of bad music out today, but in the 70s there were elements of bad music too. It wasn't
sure.
We tend to, you know, romanticize, you know, our memories, you know, and it wasn't, there were some there was some crap out there as well. So, and I think that's the same in every era. And there's great, there's some great artists today as well, you know? Mm.
So. Well, I'm thrilled to have you on the show. And I know that the new album Day by Day is out, and it's available on Amazon and iTunes and Spotify and just about anywhere you can get music right now. Timothy B. Schmit is our guest, and I'm very excited about the new album. Hopefully you won't wait so long for the next one.
Well, I'm doing my best.
Yeah. Is there anything you haven't done that you want to do? What's on the wish list, the bucket list that you still got to check off?
I don't know musically if there's anything I'd rather want to do more than I'm doing, other than keep improving, because I didn't really, I wrote songs when I was young, but I didn't really come into it until I was probably 60.
Give you a chance to say something to the troops if you want to send out a shout out to the worldwide audience, which includes the troops.
Well, thank you guys and you men and women out there doing what you're doing. We all appreciate it here. Thank you.
Timothy B. Schmit on Border Crossings.